Welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on scientific notation. The reason why we would use scientific notation is because it really helps us to simplify writing either really large or really small numbers. And so the basis of writing a number in scientific notation, so we would write a number here that has one digit to the left of the decimal point. So it's going to be something between 1 and like 9.999, something like that, but only one digit to the left of the decimal point. The other part of scientific notation is we say that's times 10 to the raised to a certain power. And so this exponent b is an integer. It can be a positive value or it can be a negative value, but it tells us how many spaces and in which direction to move the decimal point to convert our number from scientific notation to standard notation. There are a lot of different ways that people teach scientific notation, and a lot of them involve rules that state if the exponent is this, then the decimal point is moved to the right, and if it's this, the decimal point is moved to the left. I think that we can simplify it more than that. So this is the rule that I'm going to give you for scientific notation and the power that we're raising that 10 to, that exponent. And so if your exponent is a positive number, then we know that our number in standard notation is going to be greater than 1. And so that's going to involve moving our decimal point to the right, but we'll do some examples and I'll show you this. But I like to remember that if it's positive, your number is greater than 1. If your exponent, on the other hand, is negative, that means our number is going to be smaller than 1. And so that would tell us that we need to move our decimal point to the left. But I think this might be a little bit more intuitive than trying to remember right and left. Just remember, okay, if it's positive, your number is larger than 1, so you're going to have to move the decimal point in the direction that gives you a number larger than 1. And if it's negative, the number is smaller than 1, so you're going to have to move your decimal point in a direction that gives you a number that's smaller than 1. Okay, so the very first thing that I want to do is I want to look at some values here, and I want us to go through this list and determine which numbers are actually written in proper scientific notation. Okay, so looking at this first example here, I have a number, I have only one digit to the left of the decimal point, times 10 to the, again, it doesn't matter what this integer value is here, so I'm going to say that this is correct. However, if I look at this second example here, I have a zero here. That doesn't really count as having a number to the left of the decimal point. This number here has to be between 1 and 9. So this would not be correct scientific notation. So I'm going to say this is incorrect. Same with this third example here. Notice now I have two digits to the left of the decimal point. That would also not be correct scientific notation, so I'm going to say incorrect. And both of these examples down here are fine. One digit to the left of the decimal point. Your exponent can be positive or negative. It can be very large. It can be very small. So both of these are correct. Okay, so now that we've just kind of reviewed what's proper and what's improper scientific notation, let's look at some values here and write these in proper scientific notation. So let's look at this first one. So this first one here, I want to write the first part of my number in scientific notation with one number to the left of the decimal point. So I'm going to write 3.81. So I put that decimal point there, so I have just one digit to the left of the decimal point. Now it's up to you if you want to include those zeros in your answer or not. Generally, those are just space holders, so we can just write times 10 to the. And what we want to look at now is how many places did our decimal point move? So in this original number, the decimal point would be right here, and notice we moved it to right here in between the 3 and the 8. And so we moved the decimal point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 places from where it was originally to where we put it now. Because we know this number is larger than 1, I know my exponent is going to be positive, and I moved the decimal point 6 places, and so that is how I'm coming up with this exponent 6 here. Okay, let's look at this next example. So again, you want the first part of your number to have one digit to the left of the decimal point, and that digit can't be a 0, so I'm going to write 4.22 times 10 to the. The very first thing I'd notice here is that this number is smaller than 1, so I know my exponent is going to be negative. And then as far as the value of that exponent, let's see how far our decimal point moved. So it started out here, We now put it in between the 4 and the 2, so we moved it 1, 2 places. So if I were to write this number in scientific notation, it would be 4.22 times 10 to the negative second. Okay, looking at this third example, again, one number to the left of the decimal point, so 8.34 times 10 to the, and I know that that exponent is going to have to, again, be negative because this number is smaller than 1. Okay, I put the decimal point here between the 8 and the 3. It originally started out here, so the decimal point moved 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places. So this is going to be 8.34 times 10 to the negative 5th. And last number here, right, the first part of my number with one digit to the left of the decimal point. So 5.55 times 10 to the, notice the decimal point originated here. I now put it in between the first two fives. And so I moved it 1, 2, 3, 4 places. And I know my exponent is going to be positive because this number is larger than 1. Okay, so now hopefully you're just a little bit more familiar seeing a number in scientific notation and having some idea of what that is going to mean in standard notation. So you can write any number in scientific notation. Notice the examples that I gave you here weren't super, super small or super, super big. You can still write those in scientific notation. Generally, when you have numbers kind of in this range here, you'll see kind of a mix of both. You'll see numbers that are written just in standard notation and also numbers that are written in scientific notation. Where scientific notation comes in really, really helpful is if you had a number, say, like this. It starts to get really, really tedious to write out all of those zeros. Or if you had a number that was very, very, very small, something like that. Now it's hard to write and keep track of those zeros. So when we see really large numbers and really small numbers, this is where scientific notation becomes really useful, but you will see it in just moderately large numbers and moderately small numbers as well. Just for fun, if you wanted to write these numbers in scientific notation, this one here would be 6.251 times 10 to the 15th, and this number here would be 1 times 10 to the negative 9th. Okay, so let's look at some numbers now. Let's go backwards and look at some numbers in scientific notation and convert them to the standard form. So this is generally a little bit easier for people. So what you're going to do is you're going to start out by writing your number. I'm just going to write 277. I'm going to leave out the decimal points right now. And notice I have a decimal point starting here, and this 8 is going to tell me that this number is much, much bigger than 1, and that the decimal point will have to moved from here 8 places. So I'm going to start adding in some zeros here. So moving the decimal point from here in the 2.77 to here, that would be 2 places, and then I moved it another 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 places, my decimal point would end up here. So if I were to write 2.77 times 10 to the 8th in standard notation, I would get something like this. If you want to add in some commas, that might help you recognize this number, but 277 million. Okay, this number here, 6.21 times 10 to the negative 3rd. Again, I'm going to write 621. And I know the decimal point is going to have to be moved from here 3 places. But notice that this negative sign here tells me that my number is smaller than 1. So I would move it from in between the 6 and the 2, 1, 2, 3 places, and my decimal point would end up there. So this number would be 0.00621 if I were to write it in standard notation. Okay, next one, 821. Just moving the decimal point from between the 8 and the 2, I moved it 1, 2 places. I need to move it another 3, 4, 5. I'll put my decimal point right there, so 821,000. And last one, 9.32 times 10 to the negative 4th. I will have to move my decimal point from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I knew to add my zeros in front because this negative number means, again, that I have a number that is smaller than one. Okay, so hopefully that was a nice little review of scientific notation. The other thing that I get asked a lot is, or that students have issues with, is putting these numbers in scientific notation into your calculator. And so if you have a scientific calculator, most calculators have one of these three buttons: EE, EXP, or times 10 to the something key. So you want to look specifically for these keys. Some of these keys are a second function, so you'd have to hit your second button on your calculator, which means like this EE shows up above a different button on a calculator. But these buttons are cool because what all of them mean, I'm going to kind of focus on these two here. This one's a little bit unique on some calculators, but these two here, they both mean times 10 to the something. And so if you were to put a number in scientific notation into your calculator, let's say we had 6.42 times 10 to the 24th, and I wanted to put that into my calculator, how I would type that in is I would type in 6.42. I would hit one of these keys, either the EE or the EXP button. Generally, it shows up as just an E on your calculator, so that sometimes throws people off because this button says EE. You just need to hit it once, and this E shows up here. That means times 10 to the, and then you would just put in your exponent. So when you're putting numbers in scientific notation into your calculator using these buttons, what you're leaving out is this times 10 to the button. And it's really important that you don't want to hit any multiplying or 10 buttons on your calculator. Leave that all out because that is all covered by this EE button or the EXP button. So you're putting in the first part of your term, the EE or the EXP button, and then your exponent. What is nice about this is then your calculator recognizes that you're putting in a number in scientific notation. And so this is different than when you type in 6.42 and you would actually type in times 10 to the 24th power. What your calculator thinks is you're taking 6.42 times 10 to the 24th. And that's fine until you start entering in multiple numbers in scientific notation into your calculator. Then order of operations kind of takes precedence and you can start to get some wrong answers. So we'll go through a few examples with that. If you have this button on your calculator, a times 10 to the something key, you will use it the exact same way, except sometimes this is just kind of a shortcut for you. And so anytime you put in a number in scientific notation using this one, or if you just kind of want to be old school and type it all out like this, and that's fine too. You want to make sure that you put these numbers in parentheses, and then close those parentheses in your calculator so that your calculator knows to take this entire thing as its own number and then to proceed with whatever other operations you want to do in your problem. Okay, so I want to go through some examples, and I'll try to talk to you maybe about some different common mistakes you might have if you're using your calculator incorrectly. Okay, so when you start to put this first one into your calculator, one thing I want to point out is putting in this negative exponent here. Different calculators do it differently. So for some, you'll type in negative 5. Some you'll type in a 5 and then a negative. You do want to make sure generally calculators have a negative button. So it's not the same as your subtraction button. It's not the same as the minus key. So look for that negative button. Play around with your calculator to make sure that you know how to do that. And then when you multiply these two numbers together, you'll get 8.4 times 10 to the 10th. So sometimes your calculator will give you a number like this, 8.4, and it'll say E10. All that means is that this number is in scientific notation, and it means 8.4, your E is your times 10 to the, and then this is telling you the exponent on the 10. So you want to make sure that you would then recognize that your calculator is giving you this number, but that corresponds to this. The other thing, some calculators just give you a value that looks like this, so 8.4, and then there'll be a little 10 off to the side. And again, that's your calculator telling you that this is 8.4 times 10 to the, and this is your exponent 10 here. So make sure that you report those values correctly. Okay, if you are getting a number 8.4 but the rest of your answer says 10 to the something else, what is probably happening is you're putting in an extra times 10 to that maybe somewhere in your calculator. So remember, if you're using that EE or the EXP key, that is already taking into account the times 10 to that. Make sure you just put in your exponent. Okay, let's do this next one with division. Okay, so when you put this into your calculator, you should, and I'm gonna round here. So I'm gonna get about 8.28 times 10 to the negative 13th. This is where it's really, really gonna be important that you're using one of these exponent keys or that you're making sure that your numbers are in parentheses, particularly this bottom number. So if you're putting in numbers in scientific notation and you're not putting them in parentheses and you're not using an exponent key, what your calculator is going to do is it's going to take this value here, it's going to divide by 5.8, so that's good, but it's not going to divide by the whole thing. It's going to divide just by 5.8. And then it's going to take your answer times 10 to the 10th. So you'll still get like 8.28 something, but your exponent is going to be really, really, really off. So again, just go ahead. If you're having issues, practice with your calculator a little bit. See if you can go through these and get the same answer that I get and check your work here. Again, use the exponent key or make sure your numbers are in parentheses. Okay, last two just to check. Make sure you have it all figured out for this one. Some calculators, this is a smaller number, so it might just show up as this, 242,000. But you know how to put these numbers in scientific notation now, so if you wanted to, you could write this as 2.42 times 10 to the fifth. So either of these are correct. They're both saying the same thing, right? Okay, and last one. Again, I'm going to round a little bit here, but I get 1.53 times 10 to the 13th. And again, if you are not getting that exponent right, this is a calculator problem. So it's really good to take as much time as you need really to get familiar with your calculator and to learn how to put these numbers in scientific notation, to learn how your calculator works, because otherwise you're going to be setting up problems correctly as you go throughout chemistry, but still getting the wrong answer because you can't put it into your calculator correctly. And that would be a huge bummer. So make sure, again, use that exponent key or use those parentheses, especially when you're dividing, to make sure you get the correct answer with the correct exponent. Okay, I think that about wraps it up. I hope that was helpful.